Welcome back. Well, we are still addressing the big news, which is that NSE's terminals are now shut down. They're both cash and F&O, and they will announce the future course of action anytime soon. But in between, we had a listing, and fairly good listing. AU Small Finance Bank got listed. We have Sanjay Agarwal, MD of the company, now joining us. Sanjay, good morning. Good listing for you. Unexpected lines. There was, of course, a lot of appetite for the issue. Now that it's listed, maybe you'll have some more liberty to tell us what kind of growth can we expect going forward?
Yeah, so thank you so much. I think I'm overwhelmed by the support of the investor across the globe, India. You know, thank you so much for accepting AU on this day, you know. And so I think it's very early days again for me to speak on the further guidance. But our June numbers will be out in next 20 days. So we have already done around 1500 crore of disbursement with decent asset quality, and we really opened up our all 280 branches, 10,000 people, and we are on the path of building a right retail franchise for the country. And so, and you know that how this space is evolving, you know, and we got the right platform to express ourselves, and we believe that whatever we have done over the years, you know, will help us to build again a kind of franchise which this country is looking for and this market is actually looking for. And so, so I think the guidance on the future numbers, you know, you have to give me some time, maybe a week or 2 weeks, to come back and express the whole of the plan of AU in coming years.
Sanjay, I mean, a lot of congratulations are in order. You know, before a stock lists, our research team gives us potential listing prices. I mean, at 400, what would be the valuations? At 425, what would be the valuations? They stopped at 460. Nobody expected a price above 500. So clearly, you know, this is an extraordinary listing. But, you know, even at 460, your valuations for FY18 would be something like 5.6 times price to book value. And FY19 valuations would be something like 5 times price to book. Would you say that your own price, by your own standards, such a price is justifiable?
No, I think, you know, you have to give us some legacy benefit to AU, because we are a 20-year-old company. We know how to lend in retail markets. We know how to collect, how to lend, how to manage the whole distribution franchise around this hinterlands of country. Mm-hmm. And we have seen, you know, around 3-4 cycles of, you know, good and bad. So that allows, you know, gives the confidence to the majority of investors which I met, that, you know, you are very different, you know, you have that experience, you have that kind of execution capability to showcase that you can manage this lending business.
You Sanjay, how do you think it's different from even in Equitas, Sanjay? You know,
So I think they are into unsecured lending, and we are into secured lending. We haven't done a single rupee unsecured lending in our whole of our years, you know, and those companies were more a microfinance, you know. So more we do banking, you know, in terms of our asset, and we have to just build the decent liability franchise in years to come.
Okay. So how is the liability franchise progressing, Sanjay? I mean, you will have some goals that you have set yourself in terms of liabilities for FY18, for FY19. What kind of deposit growth can you look at?
So I'll be a little bit candid there, you know, honestly, we have just 3 months old in terms of our liability franchise, and we already are touching around 1,000 crores of CASA, you know. I'm not even talking about retail deposit and wholesale deposit.
Sanjay, hold that thought. Sanjay, just hold that thought. Sorry, because, you know, we have a bit of a breaking news right now. NSE will start cash and F&O trade at 10:45 a.m. We'll have a pre-open period between 10:30 to 10:45 a.m. So there will be a fresh pre-open to discover prices again. That, of course, was likely. But trading will restart in both cash and F&O segments at 10:45. So you've got about 25 minutes to go and prepare yourself for trading. And, of course, we'll assume that this time it will be glitch-free and should last till 3:30. So that's the breaking news that we have at this point in time. CNBC TV 18, of course, has been on top of this issue ever since it clearly surfaced in the morning. We had the NSE interim CEO as well telling us that they're working on the issue. And now we have the fresh update as well that trading will start at 10:45 a.m.
Okay, so that's very important. No stoppage of trading on both exchanges, and More importantly, we will have another pre-opening rate as well. Yes, we have some more. Okay, we'll just come back to the issue in a minute. I guess it's a busy day for Sanjay Agarwal as well. Sanjay, you were completing your argument on your deposit part. What kind of growth are you expecting?
So just to reiterate that, you know, for us, you know, we are just 3 month old franchise in terms of our liability. And we have seen enough input, you know, enough encouragement around the market which is available for our liability. And we already got around 900 to 1,000 crores of CASA and retail deposits in last 90 days. And I hope that the CASA is CASA or retail TD is basically a combination of what pricing you want to give, and there's enough liquidity available in the markets to price that. Okay. So for us, you know, we are a running franchise. We have around 20,000 crore of we raise money from the wholesale deposits also, wholesale lending also. So I think the AU will want to price them that whether they want to raise wholesale or whether they want to raise CASA or retail TD. You know, and as we move forward, you know, and the price gets stabilized, you know, I personally believe that in this year also, around 50-60% of our our book can be funded through CASA and retail TD. Oh. And you know, the further guidance of FY19 and 20, you know, is still for me difficult to comment as of now. But the signs are very, very, very increasing.
Sanjay, your gross NPAs at 1.6% is better than what we have with respect to peers. Any upside risk to your asset quality?
Over the years, I think the last year was a fantastic one. And I believe that this year will be transiting to 90 days, you know, okay, on a bank platform. Mm-hmm. So maybe another 10 basis point, 20 basis point effect. But in the longer run, we have a high yield book. So it can very well, managed.
Okay. What about with respect to your net interest margins? Because now you'll have to start complying with the SLR, CRR requirements with the transition to small finance bank. From the current 9.7%, how much lower could it be?
I think CLR, SLR has just impact of what, 30-40 basis point? Okay. Because as I told you, we have deposited around 1200 crore as a CLR, SLR requirement in April. And we are getting around 6% odd return on them. And we have already raised 1000 crores of money at around 7%. So significantly does not impact us on a high yield kind of book. And as soon as we are able to raise more and more CASA and retail in this year, I think this can be offsetted very quickly.
Okay. Will you at any point think of strategic alliances, mergers, inorganic initiatives?
So I think this guideline was specifically meant to do small finance in the hinterlands, and we have to really respect the whole objective around this platform which RBI has set in. And they are really saying us, you know, go to deeper markets, go to the hinterland, you know, distribute more loans, build liability. So I'm not thinking in other alliances or strategic or M&A, because very early days for us. Sure. To comment on all these things.
Okay. Yeah, Sanjay, thanks a lot for joining us today. It's been a good day for you. And of course,
many congratulations
to your team for a wonderful listing. You'll have to say what it is. I mean, 45% premium on issue price. Thanks a lot for joining us.